Hello and welcome to this UCD School of Agriculture and Food Science broadcast for our Food Science and Human Nutrition degree programmes. My name is Damien Dempsey. I'm the Marketing Manager here in the school and I'm going to moderate today's discussion. I'm delighted to be joined by my colleague, Dr. Breige McNulty, who's an active member on the Human Nutrition degree programme, and by two final year students, Niall Durkin, and Niall's a final year food science student, and with Sinead O'Donovan, and Sinead's a final year Human Nutrition degree programme student as well. Before we commence, I guess, for those of you who are logging in, if you have some questions, we'd encourage you to submit those through our social media channel, and our handle is at UCD Ag Food. We will try or endeavour to respond to some of the questions during this session, but also after the session through our social media channels. So Breige, we might commence with you. I guess this is a really exciting space, food science and human nutrition. Would you maybe like to maybe just highlight how these programmes are relevant for the times within which we live and just to feed some of that?
Yeah, sure. I think it's, they're very exciting. Maybe I'm biased because I'm a nutritionist, but they are. I suppose the global world that we live in today, we're faced with so many problems, chronic diseases that all relate to diet. And I suppose one word that we hear a lot about nowadays is sustainability. Yeah. And how do we go forward trying to feed the world globally with a sustainable food system and a sustainable diet? So it's a really exciting time to be in to try and get into that and trying to figure out how we do that. So yeah, very exciting.
Right. And I guess the UCD, the wider food and health team, if you like, it's a very expert team. Would you maybe comment just on food and health at UCD, how that's organised and some of the expertise that's available perhaps as well?
Yeah, so within UCD, we have the UCD Institute of Food and Health, and that brings together a huge amount of different experts from many different fields feeding into the research that we do into food and nutrition. And it's kind of, we've leading researchers in the area that, and in research in food and nutrition. And what that means, I suppose, for the teaching aspects of the programs is that we can bring our research into the teaching, which increases the quality of the programs that we have here.
Absolutely. Yeah. It underpins everything and the foundation of what's delivered across the 4 years. And you mentioned that sort of multidisciplinary teams, that people are looking at this and dissecting problems perhaps in a way that they wouldn't be if we were just people from within the discipline looking at that, which is clearly a real strength of the program. I guess food science and human nutrition, both of these programs are delivered by you and your colleagues in the food and health and food and human nutrition section within the school. There's probably some commonalities between the programs, but some obvious differences as well. Yeah. Would you maybe, it might be helpful just to take that at the start of the session as well.
Yeah, I suppose, yes, they do overlap between food science and nutrition, but they are, I suppose, very different in what you come out with.
Yes.
In both programs, you'll do some food science and some nutrition, but I suppose if you're if you go for this food science program, you're working towards, I suppose, working within the food industry in food quality. Whereas if you're going for the nutrition program, it's really looking about when we have that food and we eat that food, what way does that food affect us as humans? So that's really what you're focusing on, the health of the human. Whereas a food scientist would be more about how we get that food to the table. How is it going to look like? How nutritious is it going to be? So things like that. So they're very different.
There's
in
a very
that way.
Obvious distinction. Yeah. And I think that's a really nice description, actually, just in our own minds, to where one program begins and the other maybe continues on, which is great. And I guess you mentioned the expertise that's underpinning the program. UCD is ranked in the top 1% of universities worldwide in agricultural sciences and food sciences. It's equally ranked really, really high as a subject area. Both of these programs are internationally accredited programs.
Yeah.
Would you maybe just comment on that and maybe why is that significant for the audience?
So food science is accredited by the IFT, whereas the nutrition program is accredited by the Association for Nutrition. And what that means is for the nutrition program that you can come out and register as a qualified associate nutrition when you leave the program. And I suppose that stands for the quality that we have in these programs, because only programs that are of good quality will be able to register with these boards. So I think it stands to the programs.
Yeah, and I suppose our graduates are more mobile and more likely to engage in international travel opportunities as well. So although that may not be the way you're thinking as a prospective student, these international accreditations are becoming, I guess, increasingly important as well. And then maybe finally, Breige, just to the structure of the programme, just to kind of say, you know, in terms of the class sizes, perhaps the number of years, the types of subjects that are studied, just a comment on that perhaps as well?
Yeah, so both programmes are 4 years in length, and I suppose for each of the nutrition and the food science programme, you come in and you are given a grounding in the science, because they're very much a science-related programme, both of them. So we know not everyone comes in at the same level and studies different sciences during Leaving Cert. So we come in, we bring everyone in, and we give them a grounding in science. And then you go on for the 4 years and you go more in-depth in either food science subjects or nutrition subjects. I suppose one of the unique thing, the placement that you get to go on. So as part of the nutrition program, for example, you get to do a 1 year's work, professional work placement. And these placements can be very broad. They can be overseas, they can be in America, they can be in Australia, in Europe. And you get to experience for 10 months how it's like to work in the food or in as a nutritionist in the field. And that really stands to you then when you're trying to look for maybe jobs after the program, and maybe the current students will talk more about that.
I've no doubt that's going to come up in our student contributions. Professional work experience is always one of the big highlights from students and their experiences. So I think that's really great. I think we might pass the baton over to Niall then. Thank you, Breige. And Niall, you're a final year food science student. So maybe perhaps by means of introduction, you might introduce yourself and where you went to school, how you were thinking about food science, and how you arrived here at food science at UCD.
Yeah, well, I'm from Meath. I went to Boyne Community School. It's just a normal school. What you put in is what you get out.
Yeah.
And I suppose I did a subject. I did an extra subject from my Leaving Cert, applied maths, and I did physics, biology, German and geography. So I was always kind of drawn towards the science and maths subjects. So, and I also had a kind of a background in agriculture. We have an agricultural contracting company at home. So I was always kind of looking towards UCD and the School of Agriculture, Food Science and Human Nutrition. And I suppose then, between them, I was kind of thinking maybe food science for me, because I was looking at the food industry, how big it is. You see the big companies, Glanbia's, the Keepacks, Don Farms, and the problem with like the growing population in the world. So I was kind of like, I want to be a part of the solution to that.
Great. So that was some of your motivation behind choosing food science then at UCD. And clearly you had other programs in the mix from within the offering that's available within the School of Agriculture and Food Science. And then Breige has already kind of given an overall overview of the structure of the program that is a 4-year degree. Mm. Would you maybe comment just on some of the modules that you've taken up until this point? And I know you've got exams kind of coming up very quickly, so there's probably some of those subjects that are more in focus than others at the moment. But just to get a sense of the subjects that are involved in the food science program.
Yeah, well, initially when you come in, you'll do sort of general science, I suppose, like Breige alluded to. So it kind of puts everyone on the same level playing field. If you haven't done biology, or you haven't done physics, or you haven't done chemistry in the Leaving Cert, you're all coming in and you're all going to be at the end of first year on the same level of science. And then on then you kind of go into in more depth and knowledge and probably more focus towards your degree. So then second year then again it's just kind of getting more applied in the chemistry, the physics, the biology of your course, maybe doing some modules like sensory analysis, which is more geared towards food scientists. And then in third year then you have the option of going on an Erasmus in the first semester, and in the Erasmus you can go to New Zealand, Australia, America. I went to Purdue University in America, and this gives you an opportunity to see how other universities approach their food science degree.
So just tell us a little bit about that. The semester abroad program is a really popular option among students, and I think this year we have 50 odd students, I believe, who have made an application to go out next year. So it's growing in importance and of interest as well. So just maybe describe that experience to us.
Yeah, so it's basically the first semester of third year, you have the opportunity to go abroad. I chose to go to Purdue University. It's in Indiana in America, and I suppose you get to get an outlook of how they look at the food science degree, what modules they see as important, and what problems they face over there. And also, these colleges are very big. You know, UCD is a huge college, but these colleges are again like 50,000, 60,000 plus. So you get to see, I suppose, what they see as important. Sometimes they have more practical modules than us. Sometimes they have more theoretical modules. So you get to, use their facilities, their labs, and their equipment, and you get a broader understanding of food science.
The global context.
The global context, and you get to see how, on completion of your food science program in UCD, how you could travel to America and be alongside these other food science students.
Yeah, great, excellent. That sounds really, really interesting. And then you come back from your semester abroad program.
Yeah.
Professional work experience probably kicked in at that point. Just maybe describe what learnings or what experiences you had the opportunity to avail of when you were in PWE.
Yeah, so you're required to do 16 weeks work placement then after your second semester of third year, which is only it's a split semester. It's only a 7 week shorter semester, and then you go on placement then for the summer. And I went to Don Farms in Nice, and it really gives you a greater appreciation for what you're learning in college. The modules you learn, your meat science, your food processing, your dairy modules, you get to see them firsthand out in industry and what's important, I suppose, in those modules. And you get to see how broad the food science degree really is, because while at Von Farms, I could have worked in production, I could have worked in food safety, I could have worked in the the biology labs, the chemistry labs, I could have worked in product development, food quality. There was so much different areas and different departments within one company that I could have worked in. I suppose that would span across the dairy and other food companies, where food science students have in-depth knowledge to work in each department within these companies.
Great, and that sounds really, really interesting and enjoyable. And I guess when you come to study in somewhere like UCD, I mean, there's lots of opportunity within the classroom and within the curriculum and through the syllabus, and PWE is an example of that as well. But there's also, it's a great environment to get involved with societies or to pursue sporting interests. Is there anything there that you would have availed of or that you particularly enjoyed?
Yeah, of course, there's so many societies in UCD, from AgSoc to LawSoc, and you don't have to be a part of any of these courses to be a part of the society. Mm-hmm. If you have maybe an interest in debating, you can just join the LawSoc and do a bit of that. I also played the football with UCD in first year, and I also did it then second year again. And you get to meet so many different people from so many different courses, and you get to learn a bit more about different courses as well from talking to these people. And to be honest, my best friends are nearly from the societies and clubs that I joined.
Studying on other courses around the college or the
exactly,
university.
Yeah. Studying on other courses. And nearly every evening at training, you'd look to the side of the pitch and you'd see a new cool sport being played. So there's so many different sports available, so many different societies. It really appeals for everyone.
Yeah, brilliant, which is great. And I guess then maybe just coming to the end of our interaction, I suppose you're coming to the end of your studies as well. I mean, how do you feel now about that decision to study food science, and what types of opportunities perhaps do you feel are available or open to you?
Well, yeah, it's such a broad degree, like I said earlier on, and with the experience I have on PWE, I suppose it kind of opens up so many doors, so many different food companies. It's such a big industry in Ireland, such a growing industry in Ireland, and it even spans across. You could probably go into supply chain, you could probably go into trading if you have interest in business. Once you get into these graduate programs, there's nothing stopping you from moving from one department to another. They generally facilitate it, and if you get on well, you could stay in that department. So it's such a broad degree. There's so many opportunities ahead on a global side of things and a Irish side of things.
So you're optimistic and very encouraged by the future, which is great to see. And I guess just, I suppose, finally, Niall, I suppose there's prospective students looking in. They maybe sat in your seat about 4 years ago and they were kind of wondering. For any advice for prospective students that are looking in, maybe considering food science or wondering what about the next steps for them?
Yeah, definitely. If you have an interest in science, you have an interest in food, it's definitely a great course, and there's growing population. It's exponential growth, and we need food scientists to solve this problem to produce enough food. And if you're interested in that, and even in the environmental side, we do a thesis in fourth year where you'll be able to look at the environmental side of different aspects of the food science degree. So there's plenty on offer, and there's plenty that you can avail of and change for the future.
Niall, thank you very much. I'm going to get you maybe to pass the baton over to Sinead, if you don't mind. Sinead, you're very welcome. Sitting out in the cold there for a bit. Again, maybe in the same way that I kind of mentioned to Niall, you might just introduce yourself, give us a little bit about your background and how you ended up studying human nutrition here at UCD.
Yeah, so I went to St. Kevin's in Wicklow, and I actually did a bit of a 360. I started off doing Commerce International in UCD, So I did that for 1 year, and the minute I went into it, as much as I didn't want to admit it, I knew it was not for me. And I'd always had an interest in nutrition when I was younger. I always loved it. So then I decided, I hadn't done a science for my leaving cert, so I decided to undertake biology while I was doing commerce. So sat that for the leaving cert and then reapplied to CEO, and yeah, haven't looked back since, so here I am.
Terrific, and I'm delighted you mentioned that actually, because in one of the other broadcasts that we held just before this event, again, another student was commenting on the fact that, you know, he didn't necessarily come from the Leaving Cert with the points in a direct fashion. There are many alternative entry pathways available into our programmes. Students join us at various stages. We have an alternative entry brochure, actually, which we'll put up on our social media channels after this event. So if you want to look at maybe QQI Fed entry, or if you want to look at linkages with other colleges, that may be helpful to some students as well. So that's great. Yeah. So then, you when you made that decision to study on human nutrition, maybe just describe some of the modules and some of the experiences that have happened during the 4 years here.
Yeah, so I was a little bit apprehensive going into it because I didn't have the science background, and I knew I would be in classes with people that maybe had done chemistry or physics. And as Breige and Niall mentioned, there was that basis in first year, so we were mixed in with ags and food science. It wasn't just nutrition, and it was brilliant to get the opportunity to do a bit of chemistry, maths, physics, biology. So then going into second year, I didn't really feel like I was at that disadvantage. And like Niall alluded to, we got to kind of specialise then in a bit of nutrition and also then a bit more chemistry. So then following on from that, we did PWE. So for nutrition, it's a 10-month placement. And I did mine in early life nutrition in Dunone, which is based in Dublin. And had a brilliant opportunity, loved every minute of it. And like, I did it in industry, but there was the opportunity to do research or to go into a hospital and shadow dietitians there. So, and then as well to go abroad. So the opportunities were endless. And then coming back then in final year now, it's kind of, our course is quite small. There's only 19 of us. So it's really nice. We're really, really close. And we have our friends made for life, really, from this course. And it's just, we're kind of just with each other now doing mainly nutrition subjects now.
And you've got some, Sinead, you've got some exams that are coming up. Just what types of subjects, just to name check some of the subjects that are part of this degree, just to give an insight to prospective students, are you lie ahead or have you undertaken already?
Yeah, so we've done basis between nutrition and health, so what you kind of want and expect to do. And then you'd also do chemistry, physics, maths. We do food safety. We do public health nutrition on a global and national scale. And then we do a thesis as well. So we've done half our thesis now this semester, and then we'll do the rest of it next semester. So like that, the thesis is ranged so much from different areas. So you really do get to focus on something that you really enjoy and have an interest in.
Excellent, excellent. And you mentioned the class size, so you must have great contact time with your academic staff. It's a relatively small class size. That strong sense of community, good friendships within the class?
Yeah, brilliant. Like I said, it's a really small course. And I think that's one really nice thing as well, because obviously UCD is quite big. And it's nice to have that small course, to have that support system with each other. Like even coming up to exams, we'll help each other with notes and things like that and meet up and try explain stuff to each other. So like, we are great friends, and it's really, really nice to have that kind of small class, I feel anyway.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I guess just the other point, I suppose, is that I put to Niall in terms of extracurricular activities. Is there anything there that you've been able to avail of, that you found particularly helpful or that you've enjoyed during your studies?
Yeah, so in first year I played Gaelic football, which is really nice because like Niall said, you get to meet people from other faculties and other schools. And I was also involved then in the Nutrition Society when I was in second year, so that was just being set up. So that was really nice as well, to interact with some PhDs, some master's students, some lecturers as well. So yeah, it's really good. I think it's really important to get involved in extracurricular, to meet other people, and to kind of expand your horizons a little bit as well.
Terrific. And we heard about the Student Society, AgSoc, I think earlier in this broadcast and in the previous broadcast as well. But as you mentioned, Nutrition Soc is a Nutrition Student Society. But you don't necessarily have to be a nutrition student, I think, to join that.
Yeah, you can be from anything. So we had people from law who just had an interest in food and nutrition and just wanted to learn more. We had great people come in to speak, like Daniel Davey, the Leinster nutritionist. He did a talk with us when we were in second year. So yeah, it's for everyone. It's not just nutrition.
Brilliant, brilliant. And I guess, again, with the end of your studies, approaching fairly quickly. How do you feel about the future, or have you any plans for the future, or you know, are you, would you be optimistic in terms of the opportunities that are available to you once you complete the programme?
Yeah, very optimistic, especially with the placement. I think it's something like having 10 months of placement with a massive company is huge when you're going to try find a job, and as well to try apply for masters. So with nutrition, the opportunities are endless. People can go into research, you can go on and do masters in loads of different things, or then you can go into industry as well. So I hope to go on and do a master's and specialise then in clinical nutrition, but as well that is down the line a little bit as well. But I am quite hopeful, a good experience, and I think employers like to see that as well.
Very good. So you have plans for the future, but you're focused on your exams.
Exactly,
at the same
get
point,
those over first.
as well, which is very important. And again, I guess just for prospective students, whether it's this programme that they're considering undertaking or a different programme, advice, any advice for prospective students in terms of, you know, what lies ahead?
Yeah, I think definitely go with the subjects you like in school, see what those are, see what the opportunities are with those. And then definitely, I know UCD are quite good, they list off all the modules and what the modules include. So I think it's really important to go into that to see what the courses actually entail, because sometimes, like I did, you might think it's a bit different than what it actually is. So I think it's important to do that. And then if you get the opportunity to speak to students who've done the course, or definitely come to the open day and see the facilities that UCD have, I think is important too.
Some really, really good advice there. So thank you, Sinead. That's really good. I'm looking here at questions that are coming up, and there's no surprises with many of the questions, and that we've received a lot of those from events that we've held earlier in the year. Breige, I might come to you. It's one that we've answered on a number of occasions. Students logging in who are interested in dietetics and human nutrition, and just wondering about the distinction between the human nutrition degree programme and a degree perhaps in dietetics. Would you maybe comment on that?
Yeah, sure. And it's a good question. It comes up a lot. Well, is the difference between a nutritionist and a dietitian? I suppose with the programme here, you don't come out registered as a dietitian. To be a dietitian, you have to do a registered programme. And the difference between the two is that a dietitian will work in a clinical practice. So they will work in a healthcare system, and they'll work with clinical patients. So those patients that have maybe diabetes and work with them with their dietary considerations that they need to maintain their health. So whereas a nutritionist will not work in a clinical setting, but can work in the community with the public as a nutritionist. So it's not that you can't set up your own business when you do leave the programme, because you will be a registered associated nutritionist. So there has been, you know, graduates that have gone on and done this. So that's the difference between the two.
Excellent. And that's great to get that kind of summary of the differences between the two. I guess looking at other questions here, there's another question here in relation to the entry requirements. Mm. I might just to respond that the minimum entry requirements for both the food science and the human nutrition degree programme are that students must get an ordinary, an 06 or a H7 in any laboratory science subject in Irish, English and mathematics, unless you've got an exemptions for Irish that are registered with the CEO, and any additional two recognised subjects. So they're the subject specific requirements, if you like. They must also meet, of course, the minimum entry CEO points in that year of applying, if you're applying through based on your leaving certificate points. But there are alternative entry pathways, as we've mentioned earlier in the broadcast, and we'll put up some links to those alternative entry pathways into both of the programmes. Breige, would you like to maybe just comment on the lab sciences subject? Actually, chemistry is often one that people wonder, do they need to have that for the human nutrition programme?
I think, and that comes back to the difference between nutrition and dietitian, is in some dietetics programmes you do need chemistry. However, in the programme here in nutrition, you don't need chemistry. As Sinead and Niall have said, that we come in and bring everyone in first year and give them a good grounding in science, all sciences. So you don't necessarily need chemistry, you just need one of those lab subjects. And if you're considering that maybe you haven't done chemistry, but you are thinking of a career in dietetics, I would say that nutrition is a good program to undertake, and then to go on, as Sinead is hopefully going to do, and do a master is in clinical dietetics, because a lot of our students have done that as well. So that's another route.
That's a really good point to mention, actually. A lot of people have used that as a stepping stone. And similarly, we've seen a lot of food scientists who have gone from food science into nutrition and progress on via that route as well. So the subjects, there is commonality. There's very obvious differences, as you've pointed out, Breige, earlier in the broadcast as well. And then maybe finally, and again, I might be leaning on you again, Breige, just in relation to this one, career opportunities that are available perhaps to nutritionists. Would you like to comment on that?
So because I think the programme is so, it gives you really good grounding in nutrition. And because of that, you have a load of career opportunities that you can do. As we said, you can go on to do a master's in clinical nutrition to become a dietitian, or a master's in public health nutrition, or if you want to specialise in sports nutrition, you can do that. Other graduates that we've had have gone on to work in the industry, in the food industry, so for food regulation or for marketing of foods, you could work as a nutritionist. You can work in public health with Safe Food, who do campaigns in and around nutrition, or the the Food Safety Authority of Ireland, or you can go into research and academia in that sense to kind of really investigate nutrition. So there's lots of different areas that you can go into.
So very broad-based degree, graduates going in great, in number of different directions, which is always very encouraging, I think, to prospective students when they're enrolling on the programmes. I think we might finish with the questions at this point. There are more, but we will respond to those over our social media channels. I want to thank each of our panel for joining us. Great discussion. That I hope people found that were logging in helpful. Just to flag maybe some upcoming events, the University CEO and Mature Student Information event takes place on the 7th of January. That's taking place in the John Hume Institute and runs from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. You can register for that event by logging on to ucd.ie/myucd. So there'll be some very good information available at that event. The next event following that is a QQI FET open day for science, computer science and agriculture, food science and human nutrition. That event will take place on the 14th of January in the O'Brien Centre for Science. It's a morning event running from 10 o'clock to 12. And again, you can register and find out more details about this event by logging on to ucd.ie/myucd. Of course, you can also contact us with any additional questions that you have through any of our social media channels at UCD Ag Food. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this discussion. For those of you who have examinations pending, best of luck with your examinations, and we wish you every success with your future course decision. Thank you.